Hi and welcome back. Alright, now on to our next video. Now this one's about port mapping. And there's a lot of videos that actually show you how to do port mapping, but they don't show you how to do port mapping. What they show you is how to put a piece of paper in and trace the ports onto it, but don't give you very much information after that. Putting the piece of paper in and tracing it onto the ports, that's the easy bit. It's what you do with the information after that that is everything, okay? Otherwise, there's really no point in doing a port map if you're not going to use the information or you're not going to know what to do with the information. So I'm going to explain what to do with the information. And that's the secrets of port mapping. Okay? Today's demonstration is going to only be a map or a trace of the actual area of the exhaust port. And the purpose of that is just for inputting to our expansion chamber calculations or inputting to our software so that we can calculate expansion chamber diameter dimensions on the pipe. But port mapping, where we trace the transfer ports and inlet ports, boost ports, etc., and the exhaust port onto a piece of paper, that's a separate function. And that's a separate function to establish how big our ports should be in relationship to each other and in relationship to the type of application we've got. We have to establish what's called a time area target. So we have a time area target for each port, the exhaust port, the transfer ports, and the inlet. But we also have a time area target for the difference between the transfer and the exhaust, which is the blowdown, okay? And what we have to do is try and get those values in between the time area targets, the parameters that we've got, okay? The method we use to do that is by specific time area analysis. And this is where the port mapping comes into it, where we map our ports. We don't just measure the entire area of the port. We have to put that into a software, and what the software does is it basically takes interval slices of each degree of the crankshaft in one rotation, so 360 increments, intervals, and at each increment of interval the piston will have moved some distance. So if we know we've got our port area or a port map, we know how much area of the port is open, and then the next increment will be how much of the area the port is open at the next degree and the next degree and the next degree until we get to the transfer opening, okay? And then we know how much of the exhaust port in area is open, and we go right through the process including the exhaust transfers and thus the blowdown time and the inlet. And from that we do a calculation in the software which extrapolates a figure which we then look at and see if it's within our time area target. And if it's not within our time area target values, then we know that we have to make a change to one or more of the ports to get the balance of the sizes of the ports right and the timing of the ports, okay, specific to the application that we want or the use of the engine. Now, the specific time area analysis and time area targets is a whole subject into itself, and that's a whole video or even more than one video into itself, okay, and my software, the expansion chamber software, doesn't actually do that, okay. That function you'll find in modelling software. Essentially, I'm going to do videos on that, and I'm going to explain what the time area targets are and how you can calculate those easily and what the specific time area process or analysis process is. And that's why you map the ports onto a piece of paper, because that's where you use the piece of paper and the areas and the shape of the ports to input to your software so your software can do that incremental analysis, okay? As you can now see, I assume now you can understand why there's a lot more information than just tracing it onto a piece of paper that you need to know about. So today we're just going to do the video on the exhaust port, and we're just looking at the total area. So I'm just going to do a basic trace of the exhaust port in the cylinder and the outlet so that we can put it into the software. So that's a little of a bit of a primer to begin with on how to do port mapping. So, let's get onto that, eh?